So, how are you, class? Welcome to our last day, and we're doing what you call continuation of what you call measurements. And so today we're looking at what you call the area by counting squares. So we want to see how we can calculate the area by counting squares. So basically, what we said earlier that we're dealing with measurements in terms of centimeters or meters, centimeters and meters. So therefore, today we have our square here. When you look at our square, we want to identify every small square here has equal size. And therefore, we have the one main big one, and we have other small squares inside. And therefore, for us to get what you call the area of this square, we have to do it by what you call calculation. So we have to calculate. If it was a small square, if it was just something kind of a small square, that would be easy, and then maybe divide it 1, 2 like that, and then we have 1, 2. So that would be very easy. So we just do by what you call counting, and that's what we're able to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that one will be able to give us the area of that square will be 9 centimeters square. So there's something we have to introduce here. We are calling it square units on how we write. We write a small 2 on top of what you call the measurement. If it was centimeters, we write centimeter square. If it was what you call meters, we write meters square. So therefore, here we want to look at calculating this, and we are just still doing what you call counting. So we find that in our square we have different colors. We have different colors. That is yellow. We also have what you call green. Now, so we have 3 of them. We have this what you call purple. We have purple color here. We have this green, and this is what you call yellow. So purple, that is not well visible. That's color purple. This green, and this yellow. So we have the whole of what you call these are squares. So if we are to be asked how many or what area represents the area that is covered by what? The green. Now, the question would be, count the number of squares painted purple. That is the first question. So we come here and say 1, put here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So I will come and say the area covered by purple is 6 square units. It is 6 square units. The second question comes, the B, count the area painted green. Count the squares painted green. So I will come and say where I will go where green is and count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I will write it is 9 square units. That is 9 square units. Then the last one will be count the squares covered by painted yellow. C, count squares painted yellow. So come where yellow is and count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that will also still give me 6 square units. So therefore, I find that I may be able to have the bigger square, but inside it, I may be able to have different small square units. And therefore, the assignment you have, go to your mathematical page, one of the page, mathematical book. Take one page. We have one page has one big square. Then count the small squares in one mathematical page. Count the squares in one mathematical page. For example, if this was my mathematical, but this is not mathematics book, I will get this, I'll go to this page, then we'll be able to find there are small squares, and this is one big square, but we have inside small square. So go and count those small square of only one page and write down, then we'll be able to mark. Have a good day.